been counting down the minutes to when my kids would start napping so that I could do some plant chores uninterrupted. I don't know. I think it's that it's springtime, and the last few days it's actually been like 60 to 70 degrees or so. Today isn't sunny, it's really gloomy, but yesterday it was really sunny and just so beautiful. Today I've determined I'm just going to get a bunch of plant chores done. Just like whatever I can get done, I'm gonna do. Whatever it is what it is, you know? Oh gosh, your claws are so sharp, buddy. I just feel like there's a bunch of stuff that always needs to get done when it comes to my plants. So whenever I get a spare moment, I just kind of run around and figure out what I need to do. So I guess I'll just take you guys along with me. So I'm gonna finish eating lunch and then we're gonna get to work. Also, I just got my Amazon package. I think I've committed to which greenhouse cabinet I'm going to get in the coming weeks. I've decided I'm gonna get a red stove wide. For a really long time, I was leaning towards a fabricore, but all things considered, I don't know, I was just weighing all the pros and cons, and I think I'm gonna go with the red stove wide because I think it's ever so slightly larger than the fabricore wide, and it's cheaper, and it has the magnetic backing to it, which I really like that. So I don't know, all those things considered, I think I want to go with that. And also the colors of the fabricore wide come in, I don't necessarily like that much, so I would have to spray paint it, but I don't want to deal with that. I started ordering all of the fun IKEA greenhouse cabinet accessories that are going to go in it, and this package just arrived, and I think that it's some of those accessories. So let's look and see what it is. There's two things in here actually. Ooh, okay, so these are supposed to be spice rack shelves or spice shelves or something, but they're magnetic. A lot of people use them with Redstas because of the magnetic back, and these are shelves that just magnetize directly onto that metal. The Redsta itself is not magnetic, but it has a metal back, so you can obviously put magnetized objects onto it. I kind of misspoke, but that was what I was trying to say. It came in a pack of two. Oh, okay, that's actually larger than I thought it would be, which is quite nice. So there's a big magnet right here, so you just whack it right onto the back of the Redsta. It has this little guard rail to make sure the pot stays in place. Obviously it's designed for spices actually, but it's about that wide. So yeah, I could see myself sticking some small pots in here, or like tapered pots and stuff like that. That'll be really nice actually. You guys, I'm so excited. I just have to figure out a good time to drive down to the IKEA that's in Columbus, which is like an hour and a half drive. Oh, and then I also got these cable management clip things. So they've got sticky backing to them, kind of like the command strips. All right, so those are like the two first things that have arrived for my IKEA greenhouse cabinet. I'm gonna make like a full video on it as soon as I actually get it and get it set up and all that. So stay tuned. Okay, next I think I'm going to do some repotting. First up is my Sansevieria Moonshine, which I got really recently. It's in, you know, that classic nursery soil that's pretty dense. So I just want to switch it into terracotta and replenish it with some new soil that's going to be significantly chunkier. So I don't know, I was thinking this is the only pot that I have that would accommodate this plant. So I'm just gonna pot it in really shallow, and I know exactly where I'm going to put it when I'm done. So we'll do that as well. Oh, here, I'm gonna get you guys a better angle. I think that probably works. Okay, so let's see what we're working with. There's a cute little baby here. I'm not gonna bother where the actual roots are a whole lot. I'm just kind of loosening the soil where it's naturally falling away. And then I'm gonna pot it in very shallowly, just because, you know, it doesn't have a crazy root system or anything like that. I mainly am just anxious to get him in his new home. Here we go, nice and simple and straightforward. That's really beautiful. I'm going to place this on the rattan stand that's downstairs. I'm replacing my Monstera Adansonii narrow form that's there because I already have lots of other Adansonii in my collection, and I think I'm gonna just pass that one along to a friend of mine because I don't need it. I don't need three of them. Next up, I think I'm gonna do my new philodendron mayoi. He's right here, and this plant is definitely behaving like a crawler, which is why I got one of my rectangular pots. And yeah, this guy is just like all the way at the edge of the pot. I don't know that his root system is gonna be great, but I mean, the soil is pretty dense, so I wanna get him some better soil anyways. I'll just kind of do what I normally do with my crawlers, which is make it a little bit more sloped so that there's not way too much soil for the plant. It's worked out pretty well for my other plants so far that are crawlers. Yeah, he is really stuck in there. Oh, okay, wow, that's a very robust root system. Look at that. He's already started rooting from this node as well. My goodness. I mean, I wasn't really expecting that, but I guess he is definitely ready to be repotted. So I'm gonna kind of judge some of the soil from the top here, but I'm not gonna mess with the roots a whole lot. Yeah, it definitely feels pretty unnatural to be potting a plant of this size into a pot of this size, you know, just because it's so large, but that's what the crawlers need, so I'm just trying to listen. Maybe I should have put them even deeper, actually. Here we go. There's that. Okay, this is such a beautiful plant. I'm really happy with this find, honestly. And again, it's so funny that he's wanting to creep along, but I mean, that's what he's doing. I'm just going along with it. I've had this philodendron Florida ghost top cut propagating for months upon months upon months, and I think we are beyond ready to pot him up. Look at that. Those are some pretty awesome looking roots, and he even put out a new leaf while rooting in water, which is pretty fun. And yeah, I'm just going to stick him in some soil because I think he's ready. And I propagated this with the intent of trading it, so I will most likely still trade it. It's just a matter of waiting for the weather to get consistently nice enough to plan something, just because like one day it'll be 60 degrees and then the next day it'll be back down to like 30 degrees. So it's kind of ridiculous, but hey, I live in the Midwest, so that's where we're at right now. And I just don't feel comfortable shipping plants until it's a bit nicer, I think. So also need to renew my P.O. box because I accidentally let it expire, which kind of sucks, so I have to like physically go in and renew it, which is gonna be such a pain, but you know, whatever. He's a little bit funny and awkward because of the way that It worked out. He tried to put out a leaf here, but that didn't work. So he kind of skipped that. That leaf died off. So that node is just kind of awkward. But there is an axillary bud right there, if you can see it. You probably can't see it, but it's just this tiny little nubbin that, you know, someday that growth point can activate, I think, under the right conditions, or if you notch it or something like that. But that's a little bit beyond me because I've never actually done that before. So there's that cutie. Okay, so I've got my syngonium window leaf here, but I think that it's not actually a syngonium. And actually, oh man, this guy seems kind of thirsty. I was gonna cut him up right now, but I think I need to give him a drink. Okay, we're gonna pivot. These are some old leaves. We're gonna pivot. I'm gonna water this and then give it a few minutes to figure itself out, because I don't want to cut it unless it's well hydrated. But my plan was I wanted to do some water propagations and some moss propagations with it, and I kind of want to start it over so that I can pot it up climbing like a moss pole or something like that, or a plank or whatever, because I'm really curious to see what this plant would do once it starts climbing. Okay, I guess in the meantime, I'm gonna deal with this plant. This is my Syndapsis trubii moonlight, and I had some propagations in here that died off just because they needed more water than the mother plant, and I went on vacation, and it didn't work out because they needed water and I couldn't get it to them in time. So yeah, they're pretty much dead. There are some other propagations in here that have survived and they're totally fine. But yeah, I'm just taking those out. And then right here we have a super long runner, which is a little bit annoying, but I'm just going to cut it all the way back. In theory, you can propagate this at each node and they would be wet sticks. And eventually they could maybe someday produce roots and their own leaves, but the leaves would be like super, super tiny. And the whole process would take an incredibly long time. And I'm just not interested in that right now. So I am going to just toss this along with the leaves. But honestly, she already looks so much better with the dead leaves gone and that runner gone. She's not like horribly thirsty, but she's probably due for a watering. I do try to water her before the leaves start to curl in, because if I wait too long, I think she just gets really unhappy. I was also just looking through my prop bins. I found these two Syndapsis jade satin cuttings. They're both very much well rooted and ready to pot up together. I got them like ages ago as unrooted cuttings, and it's really fun. They both have these new leaves, although you can tell the leaves are kind of chlorotic because they've both been in the prop boxes, which are in a south-facing window. So these guys will definitely need like not that much light, which is kind of nice to have a plant with more flexibility in that regard. And I think I'm just gonna pot them up in one of these nursery pots that I already have up here. Technically, it would probably be better for me to like clean these out, but I don't really feel like doing that right now. So I'm actually really excited about these. I really enjoy this plant a lot. I wanted it for a long time, and I got these cuttings for like $1 each at a local plant shop that has a little cutting stand where you can either swap cuttings or you can buy a cutting for a dollar. So it's just local stuff, which is really fun. But look, that's really nicely rooted. And let me think about the direction. It's going to be more growing, putting out growth this way. So I want that to be facing the edge of the pot, I think. And then there's this guy, who's also quite well rooted. Fun. He's got these little baby roots that are going to be shooting out soon, but these are the old roots that are really quite robust. So again, I'm trying to think about the direction. The newest leaf is gonna come out this way. So I will maybe pot them right here. Now I'm just gonna backfill. I trust that they'll find their way. I feel like propagations always look so awkward when you pot them up initially, but I just trust that they'll figure it out. Let's see. I might top it off with some sphagnum moss just because they've been so accustomed to living in it and having higher humidity. So maybe that will help kind of to maintain that. Maybe make for a smoother transition. Nice. And then of course I will water that in as well. Okay, this guy's been soaking up that water for a little while now, so I'm thinking I'm just gonna start making cuts. It was a little bit unfortunate because there are two leaves in here that haven't even unfurled yet, so I'm kind of hesitant to cut them, but I think I'm just gonna do it anyways. There's definitely plenty of plant, there are plenty of nodes to work with, so I think I'll put these in water. Wet sticks are interesting. They're kind of admittedly annoying to grow. It just takes such a long time, and I can see where they could be like super rewarding or have that potential, but yeah. This leaf had cold damage. Actually, several of these leaves have cold damage just because when I got the plant, it was like 10 degrees outside and I was running out there and, you know, I tried my best to make it to the car really quickly, but you can only do so much. So this portion got cold damage and kind of came off. And here, I will move the camera to get you a better angle and not just my face. We're just making a lot of cuts. Okay. This is a really nice looking leaf. I'm just sort of arbitrarily deciding which ones will go in water and which ones in moss. Some of these I might end up giving away or trading with people just because this is an interesting plant and some people have sort of expressed interest in it. But yeah, we'll have to see how all that goes. And then this is the remainder of the plant. I might just keep this as is just in case the cuttings don't work out, because that way I at least have some insurance. I still have this beautiful plant right here, but I do want to have these cuttings to work with so that I can experiment with this plant a little bit more. So these two cuttings right here are gonna go in the moss, I think. I like to just make a little pillow for the plant initially and then kind of stick them in there. I don't know, I find that that works best for getting them secure, making sure the node is totally covered. And I will stick this in my propagation box. It'll kind of take the place of those syndapsis cuttings I just potted up. Cause yeah, we're getting pretty crammed in there. I've got a lot of stuff going on in those prop boxes. Just have to clean up, and I'm gonna fill this with water. Well, I think that's gonna be it for this video. I definitely got quite a lot done. I'm like borderline sweating right now. Just from moving everything around and cleaning up. I am realizing I'm gonna need to do like a full scale plant rearranging scenario really soon. Probably once I get my greenhouse cabinet, because then I'll have a designated spot to put a lot of my plants, and the plant shelf that is in my bedroom right now, I'll probably move into this room, so I'll have just more space to put things comfortably. So I'm really excited about that, because right now I have a lot of propagations. I have a lot of random plants that I've just kind of put in places where they'll fit, and that's not how I want my plants to be. I want them to be placed more intentionally and in a way that's aesthetically pleasing while they're also getting what they need. So I guess potentially expect some rearranging in the coming months, unless I decide to just spontaneously rearrange things at midnight like I normally do. That probably won't make it into a video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please feel free to leave a like, comment, subscribe. All those things are super helpful for my channel. And yeah, I hope that you have a wonderful and blessed day. Bye-bye. Say bye, Alphoids.